Hi, this is Wayne Mansfield. Today is one of those days where I get a bit serious and have a rant. But before the rant, a bit of a happy story with Telstra, although it didn't start out that way. I had a call from them saying, Wayne, your bill's overdue, you owe us $211. And that's about normal. I've been working very hard to get that bill down, and Telstra's become very competitive. It hurts me to say that I have to deal with Telstra. However, their service is the best in the country. Their bills have been pretty outrageous, but they're getting better. So I've got the bill down to about $200 a month from 1,000 or so. So while the chap was on the phone, I said, and what's my next bill? And he said, and I've got it here, he said it's $2,234. And I said, I beg your pardon? He said, I can't help you with that, but I'll put you through to somebody who can. So the story is the data pack on the little mobile internet I have, for some reason the computer dropped it off. Instead of charging me $80 for 5 gig of traffic, it was charging me $1.50 a meg. So that means that every time I check my email, did something, it cost me $5, $10, $15. So over 3 or 4 days of my travelling last month, the bill came to $2,000. The young guy was very helpful. He said, I can see what's happened, obviously our fault, we'll get rid of that altogether, and you should consider having our brand new turbo internet connection, 3 or 4 times faster than the one you've got, and with our prices the way they are, instead of paying $89, it's going to be $37 for 3 gig of traffic. So I'm waiting expectantly for that to arrive today at the front door. But a pleasant change from what normally happens with Telstra, where they send you around the country, around the world, leave you on hold for 10, 15, 20, 40 minutes with no joy. So thanks Telstra, looking forward to the new mobile internet at super quick speeds. The other is a rant. On Tuesday I had a need to send a parcel as fast as possible to our office in the Middle East, which is in Qatar. That's the place that just beat Australia to host the 2022 World Cup, and went to the local post office, and the young guy was very helpful, told me that it would weigh about 1.5 kilos and that service would be $59. All very well, so I presented back at the post office yesterday and got a delightful young lady who first of all weighed the package, and instead of being 1.5 kilos, it was 2.2, pushed a couple of buttons, it became 1.1. And what happens when all these parcels and things are by weight and the scales don't really work that well? So after a little bit of mucking around, she said, oh no, it's 1.159. So because the price was going to be the same, that's okay. Where do you want to go? And I handed the package, which was very clearly addressed, and she says, there's no such place as Qatar. And I said, you're not serious, you haven't seen it on the news, it's been on the news every night. Oh, I don't watch the news. And I offhandedly said to her, maybe you should, then you would know where, you know, more places than Perth. Anyway, she corrected the spelling, found it, price came up at $73.75. Now, having gone to the trouble the previous day of getting a quote, I queried this, and she said, this is what the machine says, that's what it's going to be. So I gave in, I was given a little form to fill in, and I went away. When I came back 2 or 3 minutes later, after filling in the form, this young lady wouldn't serve me, and I was shifted to another queue, where there was a more mature lady who took my money, filled in the form, completed the forms, etc. And just as I was going to leave, she says to me, we don't appreciate you making personal derogative comments. I said, I beg your pardon. And she said, there was no need to say to that young lady that she lived in a bubble. Now, I don't know about you, but people get a bit insensitive, aren't they? I don't go out of my way to make a fuss about things, and I think I said those things in a light-hearted nature, but that really got up my nose. So I just pointed out to the lady at my local Australia Post, which is Northridge, in case Australia Post are looking at this, that one, if I come in for a quote, maybe the quote should be stuck to. Two, if I come in, that the scales might work. Three, if I come into and I want to send a parcel within the international network to a well-known country, maybe the staff should be trained well enough to know that that country exists. And three, so insensitive that they walk away and won't serve, what's going on? So I say to Australia Post, lift your game. Now, I've got fingers crossed that they didn't do the restaurant trick where you go out the back and you spit on the plate and then bring it back to you, that they did put the parcel in the system and it will arrive in Qatar before too long. But that's my rant for today, with a bouquet for Telstra and a rant about Australia Post. Been great talking to you. This is Wayne Mansfield.